At PISGAH REVIVAL HUB, we strive for truth and attaining God's lens of realities.
Laugh at Satan. Listen, there are wombs that have been barren for many years. When I say laugh at Satan, I'm not joking. I think that when they say a womb is barren, they mean children. Do you understand me? No, some people have written jam 2 times and they missed filling the form this year because they were too sure they will pass. So they are going to miss this year and next year's admission. Do you understand me? I said laugh at Satan. I have laughed at him recently so many times. That's why I'm asking you to laugh. Tonight, lift up your hands. Just one hand or both hands. Let me read out the promises of God to you tonight. Every promise on this ground, any promise you brought to this ground, is not a pending matter. It's been done by reason of revelation knowledge. By reason of revelation knowledge. Every promise, we declare it fulfilled. We're not saying the promises have been granted because we have some bold face. No. We have not checked your record to see if it is impeccable, the righteousness part of your life. That's not the basis. The basis is on the written and the revealed word of God. Do you understand that? Yes, sir. See, there's going to be a gathering. It's going to happen in heaven, in Zion. And 1 Thessalonians says, so that where he is, there shall we be also. I have news for you. Every time mommy enters the kitchen, you smell it before it reaches the dining table. So this gathering is a smelling, the savor, the aroma of that gathering. Say amen if you believe it. As I rose up in the office, my intentions were different from coming in here. And the Lord said to me, we landed on the other side of the city. You guys have landed on this other side of the city. The same manner. Not because you have the authority of funds or the authority of people's promises. This kind of entrance into Kaduna will become water. Say amen! If you know how many Christians have died on this side of Kaduna, to change the population demographic arrangement of Kaduna North, you will understand that this gathering is not a mistake. That we gather like this without security, God had taken care of that. That we gather like this without notice, God had gone ahead. If you know how many mountains we had to go through with doing to see this day, just for this thing to sit here, Satan had brought prison after prison after prison to trap what was happening so that this day will not be a reality. It's all over for hell. I announce both to PFN and CAN in this angle the scale of the dynamic has changed. These are the days when the impossible will be so cheap and so easy. One day believers will gather here and weep and ask, why did we delay and procrastinate? Lift up your right hand. Everything you lay your hands on prospers. Is an unequivocal declaration. Today my wife woke up and told me how tomato is scarce, how pepper is scarce, how onion is scarce, how this is scarce, how that is scarce. I announce to you today that out of nothing, you will produce a lot. I announce to you today that what is invisible will birth a whole plethora of visible things. And I announce to you how. It will not be by power, and it will not be by might, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. I declare, and I'm declaring on your behalf, so we're standing as one man, that every mountain will be brought low. Every valley is being elevated. If you look now, the land is plain. God is coming. I said, God is riding upon plain ground. There is nothing that compares with supernatural intervention. As you stand up, as you arrange your shirt, like Philip did this and flew on the cherub and arrived at the Ethiopian eunuch, so you gather speed. When you stand up, speed attends you. When you guard up the loins of your shirt, speed attends you. On every side, receive speed. You don't have to be jealous about anybody and their exploits. You don't have to. Lift up your hands now in contentment. It's an equipment of heaven. Is a transcending equipment of heaven in the battles of the spiritual. Heaven triumphs over darkness all the time because of contentment. Say, I don't need plenty. I don't need lack. I am content with what heaven gives per time. Celebrate him with your lifted up hands. Just lift up your hands. We don't celebrate. Listen, we may clap, but we don't celebrate him with claps. We celebrate him with holy hands lifted up. He desires that men lift up holy hands. Holy there means focused, agreed, hands that say amen. There is a new season. Multiplied grace. I didn't say added grace. What did I say? 1 plus 1. 1 times 1. So at the beginning, addition looks like it's greater than multiplication. 2 plus 2. 2 times 2. So you see, they are even just at par. Then 3 plus 3. 3 times 3. That's the end of company. There are no more companions. Enter into multiplied grace. The Lord told me, and I wrote it down, maximum impact with minimal input from you. I said you will have maximum impact with minimal input from you. The only input he wants is trust. Trust. The psalmist in Psalm 56 verse 3 says, when I am afraid, then I will trust you. That's your only input. Come to the table with what? Trust. Get to 4 plus 4, it is what? 4 times 4 is double. Don't let us go to 5 plus 5. What is 5 plus 5? 5 times 5, uncle. There is no coming back. Koni connect, ma. The one that has gone has gone. One day, Agaba. When we say 10 plus 10 is what? 20. 10 times 10, Nko. Oh boy, if I was you, I don't craze. This is a season of madness. Don't look for anything that is here. Move into things. What did I say? What are the things? Things. I know that realm. Excuse me. Somebody do like this. Did you move? That's what Philip did. And traveled to Gaza. This same Gaza. And met a chariot. And he walked in the same pace with horses and wheels. He was not panting. They had a simple discussion. Do you understand what you are reading? He was walking at the pace of horses and chariots. You didn't hear me now. I thought this is the right church. When we were still a baby, we used to say we don't mind. Now you don't grow beer. You don't forget your mad. You don't forget today, mad. Say I don't craze. Now who they make me craze? Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. It's time for madness. You don't have to stay inside this hollow. When Christ catch you, run out and come back. You will not come back empty. The city will follow you and say, menene. That's what they said when they saw manna in the wilderness. That's what's going to happen to you now. When you begin to gather, people will follow you and ask, what is this? Manna. Then they will be fed. For the kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our God and of his Christ. And we shall reign together with him. Maximum impact with seeming little input. You know what? God wants to silence false prophets. He is not going to silence the false prophetic by Ija, fight. Mm-mm. He's just going to use the little things and the foolish things of this world to stop the wise. That's why I told you in the earlier session that the devil cannot destroy you until he profiles you. That profiling is to say, now gathering of children. That profiling is say, now one little girl, now they pray. That, look, I heard Lasha. She was asking me a question, and all of us. What did she say, sir? Where is the power now? So I asked myself, where is the power now? Jesus said, all power. How many power? And all authority. How many authority? No, you can tell those who are not members of our family, because we like to lick pot. How many of you like to lick pot? How many of you are legends of pot licking? So, how do you lick the pot? That's how Jesus licked the cup. He made sure nothing was remaining. So when he stood, he said, it is. Some of us, if you give us plate with correct soup, you will be confused between the dirty plate and the clean plate. Because our own made in China will be standing like this. My baby don't come. Today, now all night. Anybody move from here, you'll die and try. All of you children, una no greet me yesterday. Now una come dey greet una grandma. I forgive una. Monkey dey walk. Did you say baboon? Now my wife dey call baboon. Eh? You won't die before my time. Come on. You don't cut the flow now. I know if you preach again, you will begin to pray for me. Shalalalalalalalalala. Now, lying spirit be that. Please welcome my darling. And my daughter, Sally. Thank you. Please, if you want to sit, you fit sito. So, listen, what was I saying? Oh, how many power? No, that's how you should pray in your house. Oh, that's how you should pray in your house. Stand up and tell the devil, I know where all the power is. And it's not in your hands. It's not in your hands. It is in the hands of Jesus. My capo, my captain. I loved it when I heard Akerele saying, he's the captain. He arranged all of you here in a line and he placed Jesus at the head. He's the captain. I loved watching it. All power and all authority. So listen, if it is true that all power and all authority is in the hands of Jesus, Jesus doesn't need competent people. He didn't say, if you have competent people. What did he say? Whosoever. Whatsoever. Whensoever. There's no special time for prayer. All this 2 a.m., 3 a.m. prayer, nonsense. Whatsoever you ask, at whatsoever time it shall be granted. One day I prayed. It was one of those my fasted days. I didn't have food to eat. My wife wasn't yet with me. I was living in the wrongest part of Kaduna. The name was Anguam Pama. Pama means suffering. That's where I was living. That is the gift of God, trapped in prison. It was Satan saying, it will not see the light of day. Why does God like waiting for you to be in prison before he allows you to flourish? Is demonstrating that there's no power in heaven or on earth or in hell that can stop the surge of the Spirit. In Hausa, we say somebody will beat you and tell you not to cry. That's real power. What kind of wickedness is that? They slap you. Kishuru. Kind of quiet. As a real wickedness. But that can only happen because the person has a superimposing power beyond your own. I'm telling you, all authority, all power is in his hands. That's why he doesn't need competent people. In the morning, he went out to the labor market in Kao and he saw plumbers, carpenters, and bricklayers. Some bricklayers had their plumb line. They had their, trowels. They had all their equipment. They are competent. They know the work. And they were obviously ready to be employed. And he employed them, paid them the highest. And the price is 20,000. A day. Then he came back 3 hours later and found the second set of competence. These ones are good, but they've not bought enough tools. Are you following me? So if you employ them, you have to supply the tools for them. And you know what? Without the first crew knowing, he promised them 20,000 per day, the same salary. He kept coming like that every 3 hours. until he arrived around 5 p.m. Closing time is 6. So the people he met were like this. Why were you not employed? Is it not obvious? I have 1.5 hand. So who wants to employ me? Jesus didn't call them disabled. Jesus said to them, I need more hands. So even if it is one you have, put it on the plow. The reason is because his confidence is not in what you can do, but his confidence is where all power and all authority is. Where is it? In his hands. His confidence is not in your ability. His confidence is in his ability to make something out of nothing. The end time is the most exciting time. You know how we used to choose for football now? How many of you remember? The crowd will be outside the field. Then two people will enter. Joey stand there. So they say, Joey, go first choose. Make you choose. Choose anybody now. He chose him. Because the guy is a dangerous striker. Go now. Then me. I see. I want somebody looking wicked. You understand? Auntie, come. I choose her. You know why? Come and stand here. He is a dangerous striker. She's a dangerous backman. You know, we used to have backman. If you miss ball, no miss. So every time he's coming to my 18, he will see her. He will know himself. Are you following me? How many of you remember that game? Then choose another person. You chose him. Okay, this one's a big pass ball. Now midfield. So where Tony day? That thief. Where's church? Where are they now? All those armed robbers. They don't dodge. I said, give me one tall man there. Yes, you. Come. Okay, two of you come. This one now goalkeeper. Anything we come near him, if you do like this thing, they gum for a hand. Especially 1,000 naira. That's why we put him as usher. He's a big collect money well. Then this one, now midfield. So we chose to. So you have to choose something deadly now. You don't get defender. My defender and my goalkeeper will make sure that no goals enter. No, do you get what I'm saying? Okay, listen. Sit down now, my team. But you guys wait. Sit down. Instead of Jesus to choose like that, you have chosen Lionel Messi and you get CR7 all on your team. Instead of Jesus to do that, Jesus, come, Lasha. See the person where I want to make defender. Come on, sir. Even you are laughing. Because you will be scoring with your bum bum. This one cannot stop anything. Are you following me? Do you understand what I mean? Do you understand me? When you come now, you dribbler. Then you now sit on the ground and push the ball. And the ball will enter. Because you don't already tire. That's what Jesus was doing. In the end time, Satan is producing champions. Billionaires. When you look at them, your credentials fail. Your heart fails you. Somebody asked today, why are all the banks owned by unbelievers? It is because that's God's plan. Satan is producing what? Champions. Heaven does not produce champions. Because every champion has one destiny. Bring him down. Goliath was what? What happened to him? David said, I'm bringing you down. And I'm cutting off your head. And in case you go, I will use your sword. Your sword is bigger than me. But I will use it. And then we'll begin to kill all these Philistines to your hometown. Gath. using what? A stone and a sling. You come against me with weapons. Mommy, does it make sense? He picked 5 stones. If he had shot 3 times, we will say he tried 3 times and that the third stone was the one that broke through. No, the first stone. So 4 were sitting in his bag. Somebody said to me, so do you mean that if you sit down, God will send manna? Doesn't he still send manna? Answer me now. No, no. You don't have to struggle. You don't believe it. So I understand. Me, every day, I turn around and I ask, what is this? Something has just happened. And I'm asking, manna, what is this? I didn't work for it. Now, I don't even call for it. I've entered a realm where he knows what I need. And I'm just walking like a fool, knowing that everything I need will just click, click, clock, clap, clip. Everything that I need is just connecting to me. I'm that student that wrote an exam. When I came out, everybody was in like this. Me too. My own is 2 fingers. I can't make it. Does anybody understand that? And then you woke up and they said you were the best. No, has it happened to you? Has it happened to you? Why are you pretending now? I said, has it happened to you? Have you come out and told your mother, mommy, as per this exam is finished? And then you came home and mommy said, then what is this that is being written? And you say, you too, you don't understand. I didn't read enough for it. And when I entered, the questions were like Greek in a Yoruba class. How can your life be more worse than Greek in a Yoruba class? Unexpected victories. Uncalculated liftings. Unexpected surprise promotions. That's the season we are in. And it's the life of Christ. Sir, lift up your leg. Sit down, guys. Sit down. Lift up. No, lift up like you are going somewhere. Just take a step and go forward. As you lift up one more leg, you hear tarara, tarara. Then you will look down, look down. The rice, the aleyaho, the tomato, the shombo, the palm oil, the ice fish. See, he's already smiling because he's imagining what that food can produce. Are you following me? The moment the rapture happens, sir, no, drop your leg now. The moment the rapture happens, you can't touch them again. The 2 million you just dropped into your account, the plans you made to spend the last 16 million in your account will never be accomplished again. In fact, as you are living, money fails. Dollar, pound, euro, naira, useless. That's why he said on that day, they will be weeping, moaning, wailing, and gnashing of teeth. So what do you want to do now, Bariah? Live life to the fullest. Don't put your confidence in money. Put your money to use for the advancement of his kingdom. Do you understand me? Every time money enters my hand, mommy, you know what I do first? I'm asking him, is it bread or is it seed? I've been doing it for over 30 years now. So it has become body for me. I just know this is seed. And I am diligent to sow it as copiously as he has written in my heart. Just as I am diligent to spend it when it is bread, as generously as I feel like. I can enter a supermarket and look for a chair that I think my wife will love. And I don't look at the price. I just carry it. But that's also how, when he says, this is Nkechi's seed, I make sure that I sow it completely. I sprinkle a perfume around it of worship so that he does not think I held back even an iota, a tittle, or a jot. Drop your legs, sir. Sorry, I said you should drop it since. I just wanted you to act it. That one day you say, let me, and it will be the end. You can't touch your car again. And the car would have even become useless. Because people who had cars will stop. You know, sit down. People think that when the rapture happens, mommy, you know how we act the films? Come, let's act it, darling. You know? They say, left behind. So they think, doing, that I'll be walking. Then I'll say, Mrs. Daniel, how are you? Say, I'm fine, sir. Was your husband taken too? Say, yes. Then ask me, how about your wife? How about mommy? She was also taken. So we both are left behind? Wow. They think that that's what's going to happen. Well, let's go and have some ice cream and cool down first. Let's consider this situation and see how we can make the most out of it. There's no most anymore. That's not how it's going to be. How many of you have felt, mommy, have you felt recently sometimes that you pray and that your prayer is bouncing back? Especially when you pray and you see the wicked prospering. That's the people that are causing you trouble where you are praying. You see them living in peace. In fact, the people that cause you trouble, the husband died and they threw a party for 40 days. That was what annoyed David. He said when he saw the prosperity of the wicked, he was angry until he went to the sanctuary. So people think left behind is a new opportunity. So since my wife has left and your husband has died, maybe we should hook up. You know what will happen? When left behind happens, or when the rapture happens, the whole earth in 1 minute will come alive, realizing they have no defense anymore. Because the rapture is the removal of the defense of the earth. Listen to me. Boko Haram would have been more mean than Boko Haram has been. The only reason is because of the church that surrounded the earth. Say praise the Lord. Lift up your hands. As she is saying it in the natural, you do not see that in the spirit, this stupid, simple, useless looking prayer has stopped Satan. Because when you say praise the Lord, you open heaven and you shut down hell. Every time. If you knew it, you would say praise the Lord 20,000 times. What is coming is deadly. Bayero is fighting with Sanusi over the emirship of Kano. What is keeping Kano from being destroyed is the church. The church is still saying what? In Kano. They are a minority, but they are still saying. And that is what is limiting the power of Satan to bring destruction. One of these days, he that letteth will be taken. When the church is folded, sir, every evil walking will begin. Right now, Boko Haram is more shocked than the church. Because every evil they plan is not successful. Even the little success they have now is a limitation by God. And it's because a little child said, "Praise the Lord." Listen to me. The Antichrist cannot show up. Somebody said to me, the Antichrist will show up before the tribulation. There's post-millennial, pre-millennial. I just looked at them and I was laughing. Except the scripture is not correct. Say amen.
Amen.
Sir, you have prayed. Amen is the name of somebody who... He is the Amen. When you call his name, end of discussion. Did you know that, man? Amen, amen. What will happen? Wisdom, thanksgiving, and honor. Power and might be for how long now? Amen. Excuse me. What did you say that brought blessings and glory? Did you farm 2 kilometers? Did you dam a river? Did you cultivate elephants and hippopotami? You just said what?
Yeah.
And then what began to happen? Blessings and... What did you say? Amen. Wisdom. And honor. Power and might. Be unto the Lord. Let me hear you say, how long? What again? Hey. They call him the Amen. They call him the Prince of all the kings of the earth. That means when kings gather to vote and choose a leader, they choose him. LOP 74. LOP 70. That's the Amen. Leave him, leave him. He's a priest. After the order of Melchizedek. Don't you see the way he's traveling around with alacrity, looking at us anyhow? One day now you hear him saying, "Oh Lord, the ministry is difficult." The Lord said, "You don't chop the shine. When you were a child, you were shining." That's how I stole my grandmother's tithe. And one day I went to preach. The people didn't give me offering. And I left my wife very loaded. She borrowed the money for the transport. And she told me that her friend is waiting for my return. The people forgot. I crossed the road. I went and stood near Bola by the railway line. Tears came out of my eyes. Mature 38-year-old man. I was weeping. Then the Lord said to me, "Yeah, why? How can a man of God be crying?" So I said to him, "Shut up. That's not the right question. You should be telling me how I'm going. This is 6:30. I'm leaving Kano back to Zaria. I'm in Kaduna. I don't have transport money. My wife borrowed the money and gave me. If your ministry is not prosperous, why do you bother sending people? At least you should pay my bills. I'm not asking for much." Liar. Then he said, "Is that why you are crying?" I said, "Yes. They didn't give me offering. I don't even have 15 naira. I have a leather bag with cassettes up to 100. The least they could have done was even buy my cassettes. But one bigger man of God entered the meeting, and the meeting changed. They were just talking about daddy, papa. But me, I was not a daddy. I was not a papa. I was a singer. And they treated me like a singer. And meanwhile, I've preached to. I've done questions and answer. I was just waiting for them to say, can we buy the tapes of the man of God who came from Kaduna so that I'll be counting with my eyes. 50, 52, 56, 50. So I'm looking 500 and so every cassette is 100. So then I can see when I can pay my wife and what the interest will be. And the man of God, they blessed him. We entered the same car coming to Kaduna eventually. And when we reached across that bridge on the way from Kano, he stopped the car and bought 3 guinea fowls, 2 chickens. He bought eggs, guinea fowl eggs and chicken eggs. He said to me, you know, that's, you need to use the wisdom of God. When you return home, this is how you pacify mommy and cool her down. He had what to pacify his wife. Me, I was sitting straight. Only spirit. Neget. So as I was standing on the road, Joey, that's why people change the message halfway. They go to a seminar and they hear how to do proper ministry, set in motion proper administration. Before you go anywhere, send them a form to fill. And wives will tell their husbands, Shebi, you heard that seminar. That man of God is ahead of you. Why? Because he built a theater. You don't have anything. Then they'll tell you to change over. Then I call, Akirele, come. From today, by the grace of God and the power of Christ invested in me, I separate this, our brother, to be the administrator of this ministry. So henceforth, when you need me, you will only get to me through him. I just attended a seminar and Pastor Triumphant said that God gave you this body like a horse to preach with. If you flog this horse to death, you will go nowhere. A church without administration is a scattered church. In fact, do you want to live in frustration? An anointing without administration equals to frustration. Think, my son. Think before you stink. Can I repeat it again? I said, if you don't think, you will stink. You know, some people can call words and you will swallow saliva. Billy Graham used to call Coke like that. Billy Graham, if you get a glass of Coke, when he calls it, everybody swallows saliva. Coke. Go and listen to any Billy Graham teaching. When he called Coke, everybody stops. Is that your son? Hallelujah. Then they start, come, you want to invite me for a ministration. Before, you normally come to me straight. Come now. Then stop him. Stop him. Then you take him aside. They say, Pastor, I want to see you. Shout now. No, shout, I want to see you. No, this is the new protocol now. How many of you know that they are protecting Papa? Please just answer the questions he has to he is asking you, and then we can carry it from there. You understand? In the questions, they are going to ask you, how long does Papa have to minister? Because you know he doesn't really have time to waste. So if you don't really have time, he cannot come. And then as a preliminary, you need to drop 500,000 so that he can reschedule his program. Make promises to his team. Meanwhile, that's not the real offering, no. Oh, one day one of my friends told me, he said he doesn't charge money. He only tells the people the projects that he has to do, so they can tell him how much of that project they want to carry. So Pastor Dwayne, come to invite me to LOT. So the question is, you know, right now, the Lord told me to build a 15-story building at my property with a penthouse. The 16th floor is for prayer. So you can stand and look at all over Kaduna and send the word of God. And the building is going to cost 2 million naira. How much of that cost are you ready to bear?
About 500.
500,000. You know, although you fell short of what we are expecting, but you know, we are contented. And we are humble brothers. So, all right. You said you want me from the 14th to the 17th. I will just come for the 16th and the 17th in the morning.
The 500 is my personal offering. The entire church, they are talking about of like a million, sir.
I will come for the 4 days. Can you celebrate the grace of God? Am I not really humble? Huh? Yes, I'm humble. I'm simple in all humility. Then he said to me, wisdom is profitable. I have long understood that if you win and you cannot tell the story of Christ from your victory, it is a pyrrhic victory. That's why nobody knows the reward they will get till they get to heaven. You can't stand here and say, by the grace of God, we are the leading ministry in Kaduna. You are a buffoon. You have not read the Bible. A day is coming when he is going to say, welcome, thou good and faithful servant. And he will say to another, depart from me. I know you not. And none of us can tell. How many of you have expected your mom and you finish cleaning the house to the best of your ability? Then they say, mommy, oh, yo. Then your heart, kick you, kum, 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 kick you, kum, 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 kum. Why is your heart beating? Because you are waiting till your mom says, who cleaned this kitchen? They did an excellent job. No. When she says, who cleaned this kitchen? Your heart will stop. Because you don't know if it is for good or for bad. A lie? Do you have the same mother like me? That's how Jesus is. You can never know what your mother is thinking by looking at her face. And mothers are witches. Anything you do, they know by smelling. I'll be hearing my wife getting angry in the car. We have not reached the house. You told the children to do this and this and this and this. You're already angry in the car. She knows. When she enters, they have cleaned the table. Then she will go to the pot and do like this. See dust. That is when the children will realize, and I thought that I will clean that pot. She knows. Before, when she's upset, I will be thinking, you are always looking for the children's trouble. I have learned. She's also a witch, like my mother. If my mother looks at you, she will just go straight to the pot of soup and count how many meat. Because she left 7. And when she goes there, there will be 4. You chop 3. I used to steal powdered milk. You know, powdered milk has a deep spoon. I will fill it up to the top. Then I'll pity my mother and I'll knock the spoon on the side. Can you imagine? Compassion in iniquity. How many of you have done it? I knew I was feeling at home. So I wondered why I was. I say I'm amongst thieves. But I... You will hit the spoon on the side of the can. Kak, 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 kak. Then you will look around. Because you know it's powdered milk. So it will take time to mix with your saliva and dissolve. If it was liquid milk, it doesn't... And it's gone. This one, I caught you. The girl did... How did you know? That's exactly how I used to steal it. Then when we come to church, we say, lift up holy hands. Let us pray in the spirit. Men milk thief. Meat thief. One day I stole meat from the pot. And I was wearing my khaki short knicker. And my mother just opened the kitchen. She timed it up. She was waiting for me. When I was moving the cover, she knew. When I removed the meat, she knew. Then when I covered it back, she now stepped in. So I put the meat in my pocket. And I stood like this. What do I look? Don't I look like a professor? I'm thinking. Then she said to me, Chris. I said, Ma, what are you doing? I said, no, I was just cleaning your kitchen. Then I started passing her. Then she blocked me. I said, what were you doing? I said, Nagera miki kitchen kumakina atai damuri enki. Why are you raising your voice? Ah, it's a small boy talking to his mother. Then she said to me, I said, what are you doing? Nine na haifeka. No, 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 nekasa. She said, na me born you. See the breast where you suck. I said, what were you doing? Then I stood there. I said, I won't even answer you. Because I was helping you clean your kitchen. If somebody hears you now, they will think I'm an evil child. I'm the one lecturing her. And you know mothers are calm. How many of you remember that boy? Mommy, I don't like you getting angry. Be calming down. Now small begin. Later, mama, make you the word. Calm down. So my mother just stood there. She said, I gave birth to you. And she was looking down at my pocket where my hand was. And we stood there. After some time, I looked down to see what she was looking at. I saw pomegranate oil. That's the last time I wore khaki. I curse khaki. May it never be well with you. Useless material. You can never prosper. You are a disgrace to every thief. Immediately I saw the oil. I knelt down. Natuba, she said, this is not repentance. You stole on Monday. On Tuesday, you stole milk. On Wednesday, you stole 3 pennies. On Thursday, you sold meat. And you say you repent. Then she said to me, stand up. So I stood up. My mother said, forward, march. Left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Then she said, about turn. Left, right. Then she told me, she said, that's what repentance is. You stop going in the direction you are going and start going the opposite direction. Then I heard, bah! I saw stars. Then I heard again, bah! I fell down and said, Namutu. My mother said, you cannot die. Nami born you. I have covered you with prayer. You are not dying. Then I heard, bah! Then I rose up. I said, yes, I'm not dead. My mother was a tyrant. Wakino de Bongoot. When she wants to beat me, She will remove her wrapper. You know, they have a big skirt that women used to wear then. We call it patari. Then her money belt is tied there. Then she will leave only, she will remove her buba, leave only her bra. Then she will remove the door key and put it here. Because we're going to run around the house. I know you know. Now your face, how they look. I will enter under the mattress as they are moving, under the bed. As they are moving the bed, I'm crawling with the movement. I'm crawling with them. Then I'm calling everybody in the compound. Come and save me, oh! This wicked woman wants to kill me, oh! We had one stupid Yoruba woman, Mama Lati. Then she will come. Mama Kuru Sofa! Ma Kuru Sofa, oh! Then I'll tell her, shut up with your stupid mouth. My mouth is not Kuru Sofa. My name is Christopher. I'm correcting my helper. Oh, I don't even know why I'm telling you my mother's story. She was just a troublesome woman. Now she's in heaven. Every day I see my daughter, I see my mother. The only difference is that we are, you know, the same height. So I know it's not my mother, it's my daughter. But she looks like her, spitting image. If my mother blocks door, the door will be dark. The room will be dark. You will know that thunder has come. And you know, sometimes my wife, my mother will leave you so that you will forget that you did anything wrong. It's the same witchcraft. They used it for me before they used it for you. She'll say, Joey, please give me water. Let me add to the rice before my husband comes late. You two will bring it. Then you stand within striking distance and she didn't hit you. Then she'll tell you, do you remember where I kept my Maggi? Bring it. Then you go and bring it. Then she'll say, bring your hand. Then she'll touch the water and tap it and tell you, taste it. See all the tasters. Then you tell it and tell her that the salt is not. Then she says, salt, go. Then she will add salt. Then she will tell you to taste it again. Then you say, yeah, it's okay. Then she says, hey, that's why I like my son. Meanwhile, what she wants to do is inside. Then she will tell you, you know that time we didn't have fridge. We used to have water in a big pot and in Tulu on top of wet sand. So that it can be cool. Then she'll tell you that you should go and fetch water for her to drink. I beg, she's tired. Then you fetch the water. Now, you know what? The kitchen is outside. She's sending you into the house. And it's the house you are afraid of entering. Because she will block you inside the house. Are you following me? So because you entered the house 3-4 times, then she'll tell you to go and gather the plates that the jollof rice is ready. Then you put your father's plate on the tray. You put your senior brother's plate, your senior sister's plate, your own plate, your junior brother's plate. Then you turn around and there's darkness. Then you start, as to God, I will never do it again. Mommy, you are lying, brothers. And she has locked the door and put the key. See, this mother is looking at me like, Kai Yaronan. We children suffered at the hands of our mothers. But that's not why I'm preaching tonight. I'm preaching to you about the dynamics of the kingdom of God. God has all power and all authority. Where? So he doesn't even need competent people. So in the 11th hour, 1 hour to six, he came to employ a leper. Come. And he employed a blind woman. Come. And he employed a kurma dumb. And he employed, a kurma, he cannot hear. A baby cannot speak. Then we are going to the farm. All of you be walking like lame people. be following me. We are going to the farm. Do now, act. We are going to the farm. So if you saw me with this kind of people, what will you ask me? Will you ask me, are you going to the farm? Won't you ask me if I started a ministry for deliverance and healing? This is Jesus's first 11 against Satan's selection. You know very well that Satan will select men of height, stature, caliber, timber, juggernaut, caterpillar. But Jesus is coming. Be lame now. Be acting. People are watching you. This is Jesus' army. And there's only one more hour to the end of the race. He saves the best for last. And his best is wounded, disabled, disorganized. If you ask them, are you the end time army? They will say, God forbid, I can't make it. Then they will tell you the because. See my hand. See my leg. See my eye. See, some of you, that's all you sit down doing, thinking about what disqualifies you. But that's the only reason why the election of Christ is upon you. Sit down. But thank him. Lift up your hands and thank him. That he chose you. Reinhard Bonnke asked God, why did you choose me? And God said to him, there are five others who were better qualified than you, who were raring to go, but they were disqualified because they couldn't trust me. So God said, if you wanted to reap Africa, five of Reinhard Bonnke's schoolmates were more competent, more worded, more prayerful. And Reinhard knew them by name. And God said, but I chose you. He said, but. I said, but. See the demoniac from Gadara we acted yesterday. Come, sir. A man, 2,000 demons were cast out to enter 2,000 plus pigs, and the pigs died. And the man sat at his feet for how long? Just a few moments. And the people of the land came and said to Jesus, we don't like this miracle. You have spoiled our business. Because the people who gave them the pigs will come demanding payback for insurance, isn't it? We know the discussion Jesus had with him, because when the man stood up, parenthetically, the gospel writer said to us, the man had said, let me follow you and be part of your team, so that when they snap group picture, he will be near Jesus. Isn't it? Everyone wants a ministry of visibility. There are 400,000 people that are following Baba's page. So when I'm snapped with him, how many people have seen me? 400,000. Jesus said, no, go back to your people. Tell them what the Lord has done for you. That day Jesus came, the crusade gathered 20,000. When he returned to that land, the crusade was now 2 million. Who evangelized 1.8 million? The demoniac. Was he qualified? Was he trained enough? Did he spend enough time in Bible school? Did he know enough what to preach? Those are the kind of people he's using. That's how he took Joseph. Come, sir. I told you yesterday, join your hands. So they sent Joseph to prison. His story began at 17. Then his brother sent him to prison. Just because he dreamt. Did he ask for the dream? Did he go to Bible school? Did Joseph hate his brothers? He loved them like die. He was number 11. They were his seniors. Judah, Reuben, Issachar. He used to call them fondly. They sold him and he heard them counting the money. 30 pieces of silver, and they were counting. Okay, you one, you two,
You, everybody, 1, 1, 1. Okay, what is left now? 10 of them. They counted 30 pieces. And so they got 10. So they now added another 1, 1, 1, 1. So we all have 2 pennies, right? Then they added another 1, 1, 1. We all have 3. He heard them counting his fee. He cried from Canaan to Egypt. There was no answer. He got to Potiphar's house with his heart chained. At that hour, he gave up. Because nobody can reach him. Where Jacob is, Jacob will not reach him. And he now knew his brothers. They would have lied to his father. There are new hybrid hyenas. Their teeth, they look like hyena teeth. When they bite you, they cut and chew at the same time. Do you recognize this dress? Jacob said, "Oh my God." Began to imagine, animals have eaten my son. Joseph knew help is not coming. Oh no, some of you are there tonight. Some of you were the demoniac at Gadara. Some of you are the ones who are saying help is not coming. But unknown to Joseph, Jacob swore, "I will go to the grave mourning Joseph." So I have good news for you. People are interceding. The father of the prodigal never stopped praying. Jacob did not stop praying for Joseph. When they slapped Joseph, Joseph would say, "It's not your fault. Everybody has forsaken me." So he doesn't even cry out. He just brings out the tears, weeping. "No problem. Slap me again. Maybe it will make me feel better." Known to him, the father was praying. Those are the kind of people Jesus is using in the end time. From Potiphar's prison to Pharaoh's prison in Kirikiri. That's why I asked you, how do we take Jesus to the market when our lives are full of prisons? All we can think about is the things that are not working. Because they are so gigantic, so strong, so ginormous. The odds against us. They are so enormous that you cannot find one reason to praise God. And I told you yesterday, it's a lie! There's nobody that is so oppressed that they do not have one reason to give thanks. Even Jeremiah started a poem. The title of the poem is Lamentation. "You have abandoned us. You have forgotten us. Our enemies have defeated us. We don't even have corn. We don't even have rice. We don't have yam." In the middle of the prayer, he started, "Morning by morning, new mercies I see." How can a lamentation turn into a praise? "All I have needed, your hands have provided." Then he said what? "Great is..." No. I didn't hear you. What did he say? I didn't hear you. "Call all of the great." That's how Jeremiah said it. "Is thy faith, Lord, unto us, Lord, unto them." The man who was carrying a lamentation turned around into a thanksgiving. Tonight, that's what's going to happen. When you leave Siloam, 2 things. Siloam is a stream. It's a stream to wash you. But Siloam is also a pillar, a tower. Jesus said, "Do you think that those Jews that the Tower of Siloam fell upon, they are the worst sinners? No, it's a tower to lean on. This tower is not falling. Today is not the falling tower. Today is the standing tower. In the last days, he said, men will become a hiding place. Everyone who knows their hiding place, stand up and stretch your two hands forward. Now, imagine that people are running to safety under the cover of your two hands. Tonight, I call you the hiding place. Tonight, I call you the hiding shade. Tonight, men will stand to give thanks to God. And he will say, the sun shall not smite me by day, nor the moon by night. But the Almighty, he shall be my shade. You are the one people will be calling the shade of the Almighty. The Son of Righteousness will rise up with healing in his wings. It is your hands that are now the wings of the Almighty. You are now the house of healing. You are now the place of safety. When they say, in vain do men prepare a horse for the day of battle, but safety is of the Lord. You are the safety. You are not competent, but he has elected you and he has set you like that. Amen. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? And God said, they have taken counsel against me and my anointed, yet I will set my anointed. Did you hear that? In spite of their contradictions, I have set my anointed upon my holy hill, the cynosure of all eyes, and so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. You have been set up on high, and whom the Lord has lifted, none can curse. Did you hear that? He said to Moses, he was boasting to David, he said concerning Moses, he said, I led them out by the finger of the Lord. But then later he said, it was actually a strong and a mighty hand. Did I stretch out to lead them? Who was the strong and mighty hand? Moses. Peace. Victor. I told our soldiers in church one day, I said, the government will never defeat Boko Haram. You guys get ready for successes that you can't explain. They will send you for an assignment and you will execute it. Then they will find out later that they cut off the whole head of the snake, not by plan. And that is how they took out all these people. We just woke up and all the kingpins in Zamfara, Kebbi, everywhere. Before, they will send troops and then leak out the information. Nobody knew that day Goliath was going to die. Both in Philistia and Israel. But Saul said to David, go in this your might and the Lord be with you. And David left and picked 5 stones. And all Israel was waiting to see how Goliath will lift him up like a big biscuit on his sword and then eat him alive. Then they saw Goliath fall. They thought it was a military strategy. But why does Goliath have to do strategy for this dwarf? Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Then David now took his knife. The knife was bigger than David. And David used it to saw the head of Goliath. When he finished, then he lifted up the head. Now listen, Goliath didn't go into war alone. Somebody else went ahead of him, carrying his shield. Goliath was too armed. Somebody had to carry the extra armor. Meanwhile, guess what doing? The shield was the only armor in Goliath's armor that would stop a stone from hitting his forehead. And he left it in the hands of another. And so when David was cutting off the head of Goliath, why didn't the other kill David? Because the other man too was a man of war. He was stupefied. God paralyzed the ram. Because Abraham will not be able to fight the ram. He was too old. So God finished the ram. The ram was standing there, held by a thicket of thorns on his horns. He had fought and fought and fought and was tired. God will make sure that there is no fight left in your ram. He will tire out your ram and give it to you. That's why he doesn't need you to have money or lack money, have a knife or not have a knife. Because he didn't call you to fight. He called you to gather the spoils. Stand there, sir. Israel stood on top of the beach. And then the water of the sea brought the dead body of Egyptians to their feet. It brought their swords to their feet. It brought their machetes to their feet. The Egyptians and all the Canaanites had said, as per the Jews, don't allow them to learn blacksmithing. So in the day of war, they will not have any weapon of war. God didn't need the weapons of war. So he let your enemies stockpile it, only to wash it up at your feet. And what he gave you was a song of praise. Sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and the rider has been cast into the sea. I will sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has cast into the sea. You are holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy. You are holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy. You are the Lord, you are the Lord God Almighty. You're the Lord, you're the Lord God Almighty. The earth is full. Is full. The earth is full of your glory. The earth is full of your glory. People are full of your glory. The darkness is full of your glory. The light is full of your glory. The morning is full of your glory. My life is full of your glory.
My life is full of your glory.
Say the city is full of your glory.
The city is full of your glory.
Tell me why. You're the Lord.
Oh.
life is full of your glory.
My life is full of your glory.
My dreams are full of your glory. Ears are full of your glory.
My ears are full of your glory.
My joy is full of your glory.
My joy is full of your glory.
Say you are the Lord.
You are the Lord God Almighty.
Say you are the Lord.
You are the Lord God Almighty.
The people say that you are. Say that you are holy.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are holy, holy Lord.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
I can't get enough of you.
My life is full of your glory.
In Benin,
hooray.
Somebody say, Lord, I enter,
into the holy.
Worship.
I enter to worship you only.
I enter to honor. I
enter
to honor. This is holy ground. Let me hear you say,
hear me now.
This is holy ground.
This is holy ground.
My friend.
My friend.
This is holy ground.
This is holy ground.
Hear me now.
Hear me now.
Friends. So open your eyes.
Open.
to do.
I'm here to pray.
Blessed be your name.
Jehovah.
Safety is not a thing that will happen to them. It's the place where they come from. He said he has called you from glory to excellence, according to Peter. He didn't call you to struggle to glory. He called you from glory to excellence. It can only get better. You will only continue to ascend from glory to glory. Satan is not your mate. When you get home today, tell your doors, your name is safety. Tell your windows, your name is salvation. Tell your walls, your name is freedom. Tell your roof, your name is favor. Tell your compound, your name is grace. 10,000 you will die on the left side and 11,000 on your right. What is slaying them will not come near you. With your eyes only shall you behold the reward of the wicked. That is my testimony. See, when you called on me with the vision to follow you, I wasn't sure of exactly what lay ahead for me, but I heard you say, come and walk with me. I was afraid, I must confess. If I told you all the depth of my heart, would you laugh at me and walk away? Oh, would you still walk with me? I can't explain. I can't explain why I'm waiting so long. Just to tell you all the depths of my heart. What the joy of walking with you. What the joy of walking with you has meant to me. All this time since I walked with you. Take me deeper into the height of glory. Amidst the thunder and the lightning of the word
you speak to me.
Ah, since I walked with you. Since I walked with you. All this while, since I walked. The time is come when I must go to represent your name to my generation. Although apart, I'll still be in your spirit's warm embrace. Oh, what a joy just to walk with you. Every word you speak is life, and every breath just
revives my soul.
They're all preparing me
to
face the battles that lie up ahead.
Captivated by the thunder and the lightning of your word.
Oh, what a joy as I walk with you. That is the highest call of God. Not to build him universities, hospitals. Whatever you build is good. But the greatest call is what? Come and walk with me. 2 Kings chapter 2. And as Elijah and Elisha kept walking together, for it was the day in which Elijah was to be taken, they were talking. Give me that bottle, sir. Then hold that cup, sir. So they were talking means Elijah was pouring in. When the cup began to overflow, there was fire and a whirlwind. Chariot descending from heaven. It separated both of them. What you have got will sustain you in the earth. This that is left is enough for me to make the journey home. The only way a generation can arise that will inherit what the fathers carried is they must walk together and talk together. If you see eye to eye with me, when I am taken, what I carry will remain with you. It was the day he was to be taken. So those of you hooking up to us online, and those of you that will be watching us later, you'll understand what we were doing. And Peter and Jesus were walking and talking. Then Jesus said to Peter, "Do you love me more than the programs, the arrangements, your plans for me?" You know, sometimes we have plans for him and we want him to shut up and hear us. We're telling you this, how to do it, and you are not listening. No, in this house, Jesus must be honored. Yeah, Jesus must be honored in my life. Yeah. Let me hear you say,
Jesus must be honored.
Hey. Jesus must be honored in my life, every day. I was listening to the radio until I heard the DJ come say that Jesus must be honored in my life every day. There remained no more sacrifice. There remained no more ritual. What else do you have to give than the gift of the Son of God? Gonna hear me say,
Jesus must be honored. Must be honored.
Yeah.
Jesus must be honored.
Walking and talking with Timothy. He said, "Now I am Paul the aged." He said, "Before I would have told you to kill Onesimus." Sorry, he was talking to Philemon. And Paul said, "But because I'm Paul the aged, I'm saying to you, receive him as your brother. He has been useful to me and is profitable for the ministry."
He's always walking and talking. And Ruth was talking to Naomi as they were walking. Orpah had left. And Naomi said, "Why are you not going back?" And you know what she said? "I will follow you. Your God will be my God. Where you die will be my resting place. Your people will be my people. Their language, their food, the clothes they wear will be what I have chosen." What is that if it is not conversion? She had become a Jew. So they went. And she became the mother of Obed, who became the father of Jesse. And Jesse became the father of David. And David, the father of Jesus. What were they doing, sweetheart? Walking.
So the devil will tell you, because he's a very foolish spirit. What were you doing? Sitting down, just talking, listening to funny stories. You laugh.
But that's how impartation happens. Walking and talking.
Show me your journey in Christ. This is what I do every day when I'm under pressure. Take a journey into the celestial. That's the reason why there is going to be a rapture. It is what you ought to do every day. Do you want to take Makodi? Tell him, take me on a journey.
Paul said, "I was caught up. I heard words that is not lawful for mouth to utter."
A woman like you was the wife of Lapidus. Do you know what that means? When you say, "Hey," she must answer.
She observed every tradition, but she still had time to be the judge of Israel.
Don't say, "The odds are stacked against me. I'm a woman. What can I do?" No, that's the biggest hypocrisy that the earth has ever seen. Always walking and talking. Isn't that what security men call it? Walkie-talkie. That is how fathers discharge to sons.
And Peter had a servant. His name was John Mark. Mark. Peter wrote the epistle to him. It was to him. "Oh, how I love Jesus." Oh, we'll come back again, man. "Love Jesus."
Sing it now.